Hello, and thank you for installing your new Kubota RPG Speed Keys Volume 2. You're about to see a few tips that'll help ensure that your speed keys are properly set up and ready to use. The first thing you'll want to do is open a Finder window, go to your Applications, and locate the Kubota RPG Speed Keys V2 application file. Grab onto it with your mouse and drag it over to your dock and place it right next to your Lightroom icon. You will need to run this SpeedKeys application every time prior to using your keys. So it's a good idea to stick it right next to Lightroom, so anytime you go to open Lightroom, you'll also be reminded to run the SpeedKeys application. And before we close this Finder window, let's just scroll down a little bit here, and you're going to notice that there are a couple of driver files that have RPG in the name. You can just ignore those. Those are needed to help the keys function properly, and they just need to stay put right there.
Okay.
Okay, let's close our Finder window, and we can go ahead and run the SpeedKeys application. You will be asked to enter in your password every time that you run the application. And as you already know, you will have the option of viewing the tip of the day. That's how you found me, right? You can come back to these videos as often as you'd like, and you can always click on Next Video to browse through the collection and find the one that you're interested in. And your computer will need to be connected to the internet to be able to view these videos. So let's just close out of here. And here's the SpeedKeys V2 user interface. Here are a couple of quick general tips about the interface. One is that if you ever close it and you want to reopen it, just go up to the main Kubota RPG SpeedKeys menu and select Kubota Preference. Another good thing to know is that this window is expandable. So if you go down to the bottom right corner, click and drag to the right, you can get an even broader view of your keys. One very important thing to know, you must install your Kubota Lightroom Presets V3, you know, the one that came with your new SpeedKey software. Even if you've already installed a previous version, if you haven't done that yet, then quit out of the SpeedKeys V2 application and go do it. Those new Kubota Lightroom Presets V3 need to be installed in order for your keys to function properly. Okay, so did you leave me and come back? Wow, that was fast. The next thing you want to do is go up to this drop-down menu at the top right corner and select the version of Lightroom that you'll be using. We're about to open Lightroom, but first I want you to go up to the Apple menu and then to your System Preferences. And then locate at the end of your system row, Universal Access. Please double check that this box right here, Enable Access for Assistive Devices, is checked. If it's not checked, check it and then close your System Preferences window. Okay, setup is almost done. We just need to now go and open Lightroom. And you can either open a catalog that already exists or create a new one. After Lightroom opens, go up to Quick Develop and make sure each one of these modules is expanded. You should be able to view saved preset, crop ratio, treatment, white balance, temperature, tint, tone control, exposure, recovery, fill light, blacks, brightness, contrast, clarity, and vibrance. If you can see all those, you're in good shape and you're ready to get to work. This is an important step you're not going to want to miss because your SpeedKeys keyboard will not be able to recognize all of the presets unless these are expanded. Now, I'm in library mode. You might be excited to know that these new SpeedKeys V2 can be used in both library mode and develop mode. Let's go ahead and click on develop mode and then go over to the presets menu, and you're going to want to do the same thing you just did in library mode but with these develop presets. So here are the Kubota V3 presets, and they're already expanded. And if you have other lists of presets you'd like to access with your SpeedKeys, be sure that you expand them as well, such as the Vintage Delish. Once again, your SpeedKeys keyboard are depending on you to expand these preset menus so these presets can be found and used. And at this point, you really ought to have everything you need set up and ready for you to use your SpeedKeys. Check out the next video to see how this SpeedKeys user interface works. Thanks for watching.